this thing on? Is this thing on?
Yeah. Maybe I'ma get a little anxious. Maybe I'ma get a little shy. Cause everybody's trying to be famous.
Where's pain you need him?
But no one ever wants to get to know somebody. I don't even know how to explain this. I don't even think I'm gonna try.
I curse the fates making me report this. I promise myself. Oh, all right. Oh, it is on. All right. Well, just kidding, fates. Just kidding. I'm so glad to document my progress. Jeez. Okay, so. Here we are, it's a new year, we got a lot to talk about, some good, some bad, a lot of bad, but I'm sure this, arbitrary calendar shift will change that. It's a new year, new me, as they say, and as you know, in my centennial checkup with the fates, thanks girls, this is a highlight of my century, you gave me some rather concerning news about my heart. Or the abscess of darkness pulsing within my metaphysical chest. Yeah, you gave it to me straight. I've either got to control the temper or ditch the junk food. Yeah, well, made my choice. All right, so I thought I'd do something for my two despicable little harebrained, cherished minions. Pain and panic. Last session, we talked about gratitude, and that really moved me. So I can't wait to hear how those grateful little runts are about the new Hades Minion Satisfaction Guaranteed program. I'm actually going to do a little live reading of the anonymous surveys I sent out. So rest assured, fates, progress is progressing. So let's see what we got here. All right, where is it? Oh, yeah. Okay, mark down how you honestly feel. Yada, yada, yada. No, really, please be honest. Yada, yada, yada. Okay, workplace Wait a minute. A one in workplace professionalism? What do you mean a one? You know, you snot-nosed demonic excuses for... I'm cool. I can take some criticism. Maybe they misunderstood the grading scale. It's 1 to 666, with 1 as the lowest. Yeah. Wait a minute. What's this? A comment section? Look, I didn't leave room for questions for a reason. A list of demands. A list of demands? Well, who are they to demand anything from me, those incessant ninnies? I had to throw them in the Tartarus and watch the... Watch them scream in delight as I read through their demands. Okay. I don't know. Breaks every solstice. Babies. Hazard pay? Really? What, a union? Well, there's only two of them. By definition, that's a partnership at best. Wait a minute. I don't have to consider this. I'm a god. Who are they to demand anything of me? Those primary colored misfit excuses for... for my most valued employees of all time. Look, guys, have I really been so bad? I mean, look, I can barely keep it together sometimes. I mean, does that make me evil? Look, you don't think they hate me, do you? I mean, I know what everyone on Olympus says behind my back. I'm not some all-powerful baddie who doesn't listen to his friends. If I didn't, I'd be no better than Zeus. Are you saying that I'm like Zeus? Why, I give you three toothless, one-eyed, prophecy-spelling fates the respect of a titan, and you tell me, that I'm like Zeus? Why, I ought to feed you to Cerberus and... Whoa. Chill. We're chill. Gotta be in the moment. I
I didn't mean that, ladies. Look, I'm not in good form. I just feel like I'm waiting for something good coming on the horizon. You know, I'm pain and panic. Wait a minute. That's it. Well, what was it Aphrodite always said? What you put out into the world returns to you tenfold. Yeah. Maybe that's a nice thought, huh? Let's put some good energy out into the world. I mean, what kind of names are pain and panic? Pish posh. Boys, we're starting 2021 out with a bang. Your names are now respectively good and vibes. Like that. Good vibes. See you in 2021. Good vibes. Good vibes, baby. How do you like that, you dumb fates? We are vibing here in Hades. Oh, I've never been better. You know, I am so chill that I could freeze over hell. I am going to rule the world with kindness. I'll gather my enemies up and I will strike them down with a well-intentioned fruit basket. They'll be so overjoyed they'll never see me coming when I surprise them from the shadows with a thoughtful letter. You know, it's almost evil how good I could be. Oh, you know what? I'm so good, I'll open a fissure in the mortal plane. Yeah. A pathway straight to Hades, and I'll rise up in all my splendor, darkening the world into an eternal, sleepless night. Yeah, Hades night! And the good mortals will cheer me. They'll say, this is just the change we needed. I see the doors of death before me. Oh, what a wonderful year 2021 is already making out to be. Oh, yeah, it's Hades night. And the feeling's right. Mortals, it's time to bow on that. That won't ever happen, will it? You know what? I am done. I am done controlling my temper. I finally tried to be good for one day, and it's ruined. I tell you, this is the last time that I listen to... Ouch. right in the heart. Oh, I tell you, what a twist of... I'll curse you, you insufferable. I need to lie down. Oh, God. Wait. Can someone turn off that camera? Hello? Pain? Panic? Anyone? Oh. This is rich. Blasted fates. You know, I'm really trying to change. I mean, you always told me I'd pay, that I was doomed for what? What? I was doomed for a dramatic...
Life just isn't fair. Here I am, sleeping about, having nothing to do, while my big brother, King Mufasa, sits on his throne with all the power. What am I, a poor commoner? I'm part of the family, too. I would have been next in line to be king until Mufasa's son, Simba, was born. That annoying little hairball! Ugh. Ugh. here I am cleaning myself when I could have someone else do it for me. Where is everyone? They're probably with that darn fool of a brother. Or am I the fool? The lonely fool. My family doesn't even come around anymore. Scar. You're so mean, Scar. You're too obsessed with power and control, Scar. You're too bitter, blah, blah, blah. Oh. All I wanted was a chance to rule. And why couldn't Mufasa and I do it together instead of banishing me as an outcast? Oh, I can't believe I'm saying this. But I actually miss them. Uh-huh. I've got it. Why don't I teach Simba the ways of the kingdom? That way, Mufasa will finally see how I can fulfill my duty to my family. All I have to do is go to Mufasa and say, Mufasa, I would like to... No! Mufasa doesn't deserve this. He abandoned me! No. No, I must do this. Mufasa, I would like to help you. Oh, that left a bad taste in my mouth. I am not someone who should grovel to Mufasa. Oh, come on, Scar, pull yourself together. You could be 10 times the king he is. You could gather the hyenas and overthrow him. No. Stop this. This is family. It's time to resolve this and move on. Mufasa, I've been doing some thinking and I would like to help teach Simba the ways of the kingdom and be by your side if you'll let me. Oh. Yes. Yes, that feels much better. Mufasa and I. Together.
Man of my virtue, I am thusly proud. One on one for... quarter two. Yes, excellent. There they are. Bienvenue. Today's student is Francais to Anglais. I cannot see or hear you, but I presume this is because of the orientation of this pre-established appointment. The Archdeacon informs me that we've all seemed to have such a tumultuous time shifting things, but I'm certainly not to waste any more time fussing over that. No, no. What you must do whilst I am to instruct you is to transcribe your answers. Oh, yes, there. You have already entered something. Yes, exquisite. Well, now that we have all the mechanics of this contraption sorted, let us get on with it. Yes, yes, allons-y. All right, student. I will continue to speak in English for the remainder of the course. If ever you feel inept, perhaps you should seek retribution. I can recommend that a pure spirit resolves all of life's ailments. Here we are. Shall we begin by reviewing your alphabet today? The first letter is... correct! A. First of the alphabet. What are animals that begin with the letter A? Student? Has the connectivity I see you have entered something new. The letter A. Name something with the letter A. Apple. Well, it does begin with the same letter I've provided. Can apples talk? Precisely, student. Very well. Let us simply name things that begin with the letter. No. We will move along. Anything will do now. Yes, all right now. This letter is... find it on your keyboard. There we are. B, yes. And what begins with B, student? Bleu is correct, though it is quite temperamental how the language varies, if you ask me. But never you mind the spelling. Let's find another word. How about bonfire? Bell? What is next? You say the next letter is B, student? I see. C. I scrolled too far. Yes, C. Cement? Good. Cathedral also begins with the letter C. Oh, a true phenomenon this is, huh? Now, next letter. No, it is not E. There is one prior that is quite significant. No, student, not F. It goes A, B, C. Now, we already said E. Come now. What letter follows in sequence? It initiates words like death, deformed, dumb. Student, you have not seen dumb, though it may have kissed you upon your deliverance. And never mind you what that means. Moving along, the letter is D. Take this down now. C, then D. D, then E. Excellence! A word of such grandeur, the epitome of expectation. Precisely, yes, student. Egg. A letter that emanates and exudes eloquence. Very well done, student. The next. What? What did you just say? Am I reading that correctly? I'm... F is for Frollo. No. I've read what you've entered, but there are words you may choose from to better suit your needs. You may use these alternate words beginning with an F in everyday conversation. Master Frollo taught me this, or fire engulfed that. It's as simple as day. Festivals I certainly would not encourage to attend, let alone speak of every day. With whom would you even care to attend a festival with? They're for plebeians, for scum who lack the... You wouldn't know. You've never been to a festival. Well, that's certainly a blessing you should count. The Lord smiles down upon you in unwavering joy. Not old enough. Well, I certainly wouldn't expect you to be old enough for a festival, but I do expect you to steer clear as far as you may manage. F is for Frollo. Let us move... No, student, F is fine for now. Well, that is bizarre, isn't it? The phenomenon of having multiple words begin with the same letter, meaning completely different things, isn't lost on you. What an astute observation. Oh, and what a beautiful experience to share, tutor and student. Now that that's been settled... Yes, yes, frog also starts with F. And so does fire, freedom, faith. And the first word was fire. And I suppose the best example would be hellfire. Well, not quite. It does start with a letter other than F. Excellent attention to detail, student. Now, let's certainly apply that to all aspects of the lesson, Very good. All right. Oh. Un moment, s'il vous plaît. What took you so long? Yes, I'm in the session now. No, it's not. The student is incorrigible. I cannot continue to work under the... A baby? A monster! No, I will not be recommending any of the other archdeacons. Do you realize who I am? I am the venerable archdeacon of Notre Dame. I will not stand for this. I've had enough. And now I'm going to do something I should have done 20 years ago. I'm going to have a word with... Well, this is purely a waste... Yes, they are. Why?
Good day, my royal subjects. I mean, friends. Sorry, I'm still getting used to the new power dynamic. For those of you who don't know me, I am the artist formerly known as Prince John. And for a time I was King John. But now I am John. Just John. And that's okay, because this is not about me. This is about raising money for those who are less fortunate. This is John's Fundraiser Extravaganza. Today is a day of giving back and raising money for those who are less fortunate. And while I did recently come into some financial troubles, I will have you know that I would have done this fundraiser either way. Because... I care about you peasants. People. So now is the time to open your hearts, and more importantly, open your wallets and let the money fall into the pockets of those who need it most. Let's take a look and see how much money we've collected already. Drum roll, please. We have currently raised a total of... 23 shillings. That's it. I mean, that's it. It's great. It's great. Oh. Oh, it seems we have another donation that just came in. Let's see. This donation is courtesy of Betty from Nottingham. She said, "Sorry, I wish I could give more, but it's all I have in the world. Well, but if it helps someone who has a harder life than me, then I'm happy to give what I can." Well, isn't that nice, Betty? Thank you, Betty, for your contribution of 1 sixpence. 1 single sixpence. We're really breaking the bank with that donation, aren't we, Betty? While we wait for more of those generous donations to roll in, we will have a musical performance, as is customary with fundraisers such as these. Or so I've heard. Please welcome, for your listening pleasure, me! I wrote this myself. It came from a deep place inside of me. It's a story of perseverance and optimism in light of horrible circumstances. It's called Woe Is Me. Woe is me. Poor, poor me. Shed tears for me. For me, for me. Life was once so easy for me. But now my life is a quandary. Who is going to care for me? And who will wash my laundry? Woe is me. Woe is me. Shed tears for me. For me. For me. Woe is me. Woe is me. Shed tears for me. For me. Everything I had was taken from me. Me, the most humble, noble king. I only had the most basic necessities. Just 12 servants, 10 horses, and a diamond ring. Woe is me. Poor, poor me. Shed tears for me. Poor, poor me. This life with no money, it ain't no good. I blame it all on that infernal Robin Hood. There's nothing worse than being poor. If I don't have money, what good am I for? Woe is me. Woe is me. Shed tears for me. For me. For me. Woe is me. Woe. 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 Is. Me. It seems that some of you have written to let me know how much you loved my song. This comment is from Bernard of Birmingham. He wrote in, "I wish this guy was still king." Well, oh, isn't that sweet? "I wish he was still king so he could go back to ruling the kingdom, and then we wouldn't have to hear him sing this awful song ever again." Well, you can't win everyone's approval, I suppose. Let's read the next comment. This one is from Genevieve of Kessel Rock, who writes in to say, "You can't put a price tag on true talent." I couldn't agree more. "However, if I was going to put a price tag on John's singing ability, it would be worth negative 1,000 shillings. Well, Genevieve, I think your taste in music is worth negative 1,000,000 shillings. Next comment. Gregory Dungface says, "I haven't eaten for 10 days, and the pains of starvation don't compare to the pain in my ears from hearing this awful song. All right, you know what? This is over. This blasphemy is over. This fundraiser is over. This charade is over. You all want to know where your donations are going. You want to know which poor unfortunate souls are getting your hard-earned coins. They're going to me." Me. Yes, that's right. Me. Because I deserve them. I should have never lost my riches to begin with. I should be the wealthiest being in the land. I should be king. And when I'm back on top, you'll see. You'll all be sorry. Every last one of you poor, pathetic creatures will all bow down to me. And you know what? You'll all be taxed more than ever before. Taxes. Taxes. Beautiful, lovely taxes. Well, it seems we have a new donation. This one is from Robin and Maid Marian of Loxley. Oh, they've included a message with their donation. Well, this ought to be good. Hey, PJ. I know we haven't always seen eye to eye, especially in regards to the redistribution of wealth, but I hope you're doing okay. You've never known what it's like to be poor, to have nothing, and I'm sure that's scary. Anyway, here's some money to get you back on your feet. Be sure to pay it forward as soon as you can. Good or bad, it all comes back around in the end. Love, Robin and Marian. P.S. I liked your song. Would love to sing together sometime. Well, you know what? That was the first time anyone has ever asked me if I'm okay. I guess when you have money, people assume that you have it all. That you have no worries. And it's true. I used to be able to get anything I wanted with a snap of my fingers. But now I have nothing. I am nothing. No! No more thumb sucking. No more coddling. No more pitying myself because I don't get everything I want. To all of my royal subjects, people out there listening, mark my words. I, John, pledge to do good, to be good, to be generous and giving, even when I have nothing to give, and especially when I have everything to give. Because if there is one thing that I've learned, it's that everybody needs help in different ways. And it is up to all of us to help those who need it most. Which is why I will donate all 23 shillings and one lousy sixpence to others who need it more than I. Ah! Tax the rich and give to the poor. Thank you all for tuning in. I'm John, and you're all wonderful. Thank you. And have a glorious day! Oh, I have to turn the... Okay.
Ding dong. Trick or treat.
Hello there. Hi. You guys. Ooh, you look scary. Very, very scary. frightening. You children. Oh, really frightened. Shit.
Let's try again.
Oh, Jesus fucking Christ.
Let's just try it again.
Yep, okay. From the top? Yep, okay. From the top.
Ding dong. Trick or treat.
Oh, well, hi there. You guys look great. Here you go. You all look really, everyone looks good. Take candy.
Thank you.
Don't take too much.
Cancel.
Fuck. Sorry.
We talked about this.
No, sorry. Shit. Sorry. Don't cough. I'm not doing this.
Don't say that.
I'm just not cut out for it.
Let's go over the script.
I don't want to.
Well, I'd really like to.
I'm calling it off.
You have the pro-con list we made?
Nah.
You have it.
No, you have it.
We both know that's not possible.
Fine. Cons!
Read the pros first.
Let's read the cons first.
Fine.
Cons. One, I hate children.
Okay.
Two, that candy is mine.
Yep.
Three, Halloween equals death.
You didn't write that. Good lord.
Four, my therapy said I don't have to.
But what Jane said.
And five, I don't have a costume.
You don't have a costume.
What? No, I don't fit our lederhosen anymore. I just don't fit them.
I meant your Shrek costume.
That was a one-time thing, Gretel.
Well, everyone loved it.
Yeah, because it was a Shrek-themed birthday party, so I fit in. Come on, be serious.
Okay, let's read the pros.
I don't want to.
I'd really like to hear them.
Fine. Pros. One, make children less scared of me.
Which you've said you've wanted.
Yeah, I said that once.
Cancel.
Two, we have a lot of candy.
Yep, we do.
From the fucking settlement. So it's not like I have that candy for a fucking fun reason, you know that. Nasty fucking witch, nasty fucking schlumper, nasty fucking hostage candy. Oh, yeah, I have a lot of candy, but at what fucking price, right? Jesus Christ, it's like if you get fucking money for being fucking knifed, and then someone's like, oh, well, you're being sort of greedy for that money. And it's like, oh, well, that person was sort of greedy when they knifed me.
No one knifed us, Hans.
Oh, right. She just tried to eat us. Way better.
Okay, but you don't need all this candy.
Well, of course I don't. I haven't eaten candy for 20 years, but you know my point. My point is that I haven't used a stove for 20 years either. Like, people don't understand the lifetime price you pay when shit like this happens to you. No one. I mean, and sure, I invested wisely. I've done quite well. Does that mean I have to give it all away? I mean, you know who could have given all away? It's a fucking rich!
Let's go on to number three.
I don't want to talk about this anymore. I really don't. I mean, here's what I know. There are people who change, and there are people who don't change, but both types of people die, so I think I'll just stay me, and it won't matter to anyone.
Stop it.
I don't want to talk about this anymore. This whole holiday is spazing nonsense.
Fine.
What?
Fine, let's not talk about it.
Great. Excellent.
But then I'll have to go.
What?
I have a busy day.
What were you
doing? A lot of appointments.
With who?
You don't know them.
Okay, shut up, let's watch TV.
You're watching too much TV.
No, I'm not.
Then why do I have an American accent?
What?
You watch Deadliest Catch all day, and now you can't even remember your sister's voice?
I remember your voice.
Then how come you're German, and I'm from, I don't know, Ohio?
I don't know anything about Ohio, and I don't watch too much TV. I don't.
Fine. Well, either way, I'm just absolutely booked. I don't know what to tell you.
I know what you're doing.
What am I doing?
Fucking reverse... Whatever. Jane does it.
You should call Jane.
I hate Jane. She charges too much.
What else are you spending it on?
Nothing. Whatever. Video games.
You live alone. You have no dependents. You go out to eat once a month with Little Red.
Oh, yeah. If that doesn't cost me an arm and a leg. She goes on The View once, and suddenly it's all about Zagat.
I'm leaving, Hansel.
Wait, no. Stop it. Stay. I'll read it, okay? I'll read it.
Okay.
Three, Jane thinks it would be good for my mental health.
That is what she said.
Yeah.
And she is a trained professional.
Debatable.
Hansel.
Yes, fine, she's smart. Jane is very smart.
Read four.
Come on.
Just read it.
Four. I promised Gretel I wouldn't give up.
Give up on what?
I don't know.
Hansel.
Being alive?
Louder.
Being alive. I wouldn't give up on being alive.
Yeah. You promised me that. Right before we said goodbye, you promised me.
I remember. I was there. Yeah, I could break a promise.
Well, that would be really shitty.
Yes, right. I don't want to be shitty.
Just Halloween.
Yeah, it's just... I decided that I was someone who didn't do things for a long time.
I know.
We both decided that.
And I regretted it.
Yeah. I do remember your voice, okay? It's just easier not remembering you all the way.
I understand.
It's just easier for me. Can we practice again?
Yeah.
I'm not gonna say that much to the kids.
They're good.
Yeah, I'm just gonna keep it simple.
Good plan. Ding dong. Trick or treat.
Oh, hi there. You guys look great. Gret? What do I do? Gret?
Hello, everyone. I would like to thank you all for logging on from your dens to listen to my announcement today. I know I've often been viewed as a lone wolf, but I appreciate the forest support, and I think you'll be appreciative of what I wish to announce. As of today, I, Bigelow B. Wolf, I'm officially a vegetarian. I know. Surprising, but I really do feel like this is the best course of action for me. It's so hard these days to know what an acceptable diet is, but I do feel really good about this one. I've been experimenting with kale recently. Kale, yes, and there's so much you could do with tofu and beans. They have a giant amount of potential. I've been testing out the diet a few days, and I feel confident and comfortable now announcing the change. I'm a vegetarian. Now, I know, there's some nasty rumors going around. Once I got scribed that nickname, Big Bad, there was a lot of people looking for, you know, like tabloid stories. But most of these rumors are wrong. Remember, it was proven that the little boy did cry wolf, and I had nothing to do with it. So, I hope that this noticeable change is in my diet will quell all the future rumors. I'll be eating nothing but delicious, nutritious vegetables. Now I know some people are saying, and this is one of those ugly rumors that I need to do this for physical reasons. And I'm not changing my diet because it's right, but because my stomach was filled with stones with a bad encounter with a woodsman. But no, that's not why I'm doing it. I really do love zucchini. I love lentils and apricots. And I just learned from this cook, Peter, all the amazing things that you could do with pumpkin. It's this is a lifestyle choice I am fully behind. It's not my stomach that's deciding things, it's my mind. It's a new year. I wanted to see how I could change to be the best version of myself. This seemed like the best way. I mean, yeah, okay. If I had to pinpoint a time when I started to think about this change, it was definitely after all that fallout with the three little pigs. Who would have thought those pigs were the most beloved edible animal? But I think that salad is going to take up the majority of my diet, and that's exciting. I like that there are so many different kinds of salad. You know, you can mix up the ingredients. Basically, it can be different anytime you make one. You can have spinach or lettuce. There are croutons. You can choose the toppings. Throw in a little cheese. Some creatures might even throw a little meat on top. An omnivore might do that. Like a little pig. You know, for variety of diet. I won't, though. Nope. Now my vegetarianism. I won't be harming any other creatures now. I can already feel a positive change with this decision. I feel healthier. Honestly, I think my howling is even better, too. Well, wow. Thank you for supporting me. I can see from all of your comments that you all have a lot of questions, but I'm not doing a Q&A today. I just want to let you all know about my new delicious diet. Whew, yeah, I bet some of you think that this is too much of a change. You think it's unnatural. Predators should eat prey. It's the way of the world. Pigs are fattened up every day and devoured. And you're telling me that someone who lives in a straw house isn't asking for someone to blow it down, barely huffing and puffing, and it was ready to fall, and that pig knew it. Yeah, but hey, getting off topic. So, I want all of my fans, that's you, to send me your favorite veggie recipes. I'll try them out, let you know which ones I think is a howling good time. And if anyone else has been considering going vegetarian, let's do it together. It's a good time to follow my lead. We can do it. And it should be an easy change. It's so hard to know who's appropriate to eat and not these days. But this will clear up any confusion. I'll just eat plants. I love eating plants. So, yeah, that's all for now. No, 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 no more questions. No, no. Oh, well, I deny any rumor that I ate an old woman dressed up in her clothes and then tricked her granddaughter so I could eat her. I'm gonna go make a salad.
Make sure everything is fine. See, I've got your toy. Huh, toy. See, I've got your toy. It's so soft and cute and colorful. Yeah. No toy. Okay, that's okay. We'll just sing. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wondered what you are. Up above the world so high. No singing. That's okay. That's okay. You should be happy. Your mommy was some drugged up white trash whore, and I'm gonna be your daddy now and give you everything you want. I won't trade you in for a good hit or a few $100. I won't let you sit for hours in your own filth. I will love you because you're what I always wanted. Oh, all right, demon spawn! I'm just trying to give you tender love and affection like I never had. It really is my hope to be the best father possible. I know. I can weave you some gold! Yeah, babies love shiny things. See? Everyone loves gold. And there's lots more where that came from. As long as we have hay, or grass, or anything with a long stalk, really, I can give you all the gold you want. Oh, no, don't. No, 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 don't put that in your mouth. Ooh, disgusting. Junior? Oh my god, did he swallow it? Rumple Junior, you really can't eat anything this small! You might choke and we can't have that. Besides, really not supposed to eat gold. It's best enjoyed when you look at it or use it to get things. And you'll be able to get whatever you want. Yes, you will. Yes, you will. This time around, no one can take me away from you. I don't have to worry about haughty princesses going back on their deals or anyone spying on me in the night to try to guess my name. Oh, after centuries of those old tricks, I found a way to get a child that no one can take. The adoption agency has my name and they don't care. And no, they don't. No, 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 they don't. Yes. That's it. Fall asleep to the sound of Daddy's voice. Tonight, my plans I make. Tomorrow, the baby I take. Well, I don't have to take you this time. You're all mine. Forever.
And that meth whore can't say any different. Or the deadbeat she calls a boyfriend. No one will ever win the game. Rumpelstiltskin is our name. Oh, my beautiful boy. Sleep. Sleep now. Oh, I'll have so much to teach you when you get older. We'll weave gold together. We'll travel from town to town. What a wonderful life we'll have. Just you and me. A family. Tonight, my plans I make. Tomorrow, the baby I cake. No, that's not it. Bake? Oh, definitely not. Take, make, fake, rake, shake. Wake. Tomorrow, the baby I wake. No one will ever win the game. Rumpelstiltskin is our name.
Choosing me to be the keynote speaker for the 4,732nd annual Sicalia Conference. I will now be taking questions. You there with the red gills. I'm sorry, can you repeat that? Should all standard contracts include a voice-stealing clause? No. You and your client should create a contract suitable to your situation together. Yes, I'll take another one. Yes, the young lady with the blue tentacles. Do you need an underwater lair inside a dead leviathan? No. I just happened to be there because the rent was cheap and I was a bit of a persona non grata with the royal family. Are there any other questions? Do I only go after teenage princesses? Do I look good? I understand that I am quite known for the whole mermaid debacle, but honestly, it was blown way out of proportion, and no, I am not a cradle robber. You there with the footlong beak? I didn't choose to be evil because I'm not evil. Screw it, I'm tired. For decades, I kept my silence. So I'm here to lay it all out. Because if you, my sisters, my fellow Sicalias, have decided to judge me from one story rather than my body of work, how can I expect to be accepted by others differently? Huh? So, let me tell you the story that Disney doesn't want you to hear. Let's go back to a time when I was still in the castle and King Triton lived happily with Queen Athena. And this was before they had kids, before the children. Yes. Now, Athena she was lovely and graceful and everyone adored her. She was my best friend. And King Triton was, well, he didn't deserve her. And I told her before the marriage, but she was so enthralled by his everything. She up and married him, becoming queen, and then all of that fun stuff. And with that, I got the lovely title of being the royal family's witch. And in the palace. Oh, in the palace. Oh, now I was thriving. My magic helped negotiate contracts, keep peace between the denizens of the deep, and expand our knowledge of the dry world above. Now, I had a name for myself, made by myself. I was Ursula. But does anyone know about that? No, even though it's laid out in my LinkedIn profile. Anyway, where was I? Yes. I was Ursula. And then King Triton went and stuck his trident where it didn't belong. Mm-hmm. And it was so obvious because that child came out looking nothing like Athena and everything like this lady-in-waiting harlot. But he was king, and so he locked that poor girl up in some gilded cage of a room with her mother and swept it under the rug. Then he had another daughter, not by Athena. A cook. And then another one by the royal seamstress. And then another, and then another, and you get the picture? So now there are 6 illegitimate children swimming about in secret rooms in the palace, and Athena was the laughing stock of the entire kingdom. And then Triton wasn't doing much better. Now, his indiscriminate taste gave him the label of loose lamprey. It was talked about all over Atlantica. I didn't give much thought to his reputation, but Athena, how clutches were near each other when we were eggs, and when we hatched, we just clicked. And to see her be thought of as weak, as barren, as immoral, that made my blood boil. So I planned on something simple, making the loose lamprey the limp lamprey, if you know what I mean. Now, just whenever he wasn't around Athena, so she could have a clutch of her own and carry true heirs to the throne. Now, the rumors of Triton's hidden children spread. Merfolk worried about a split kingdom, an heirless kingdom. It's made Triton seem weak and immoral. So who comes to visit Ursula's chamber in the middle of the night? You bet your bottom dollar it was King Triton. He asked me to make it go away. I wasn't gonna do it. But then I thought of all the nights that Athena spent alone in bed waiting for her husband. And so I struck a deal. Now Triton needed to give Athena a legitimate heir and not to stray away from her again. And in turn, I would cast a spell over the kingdom, making Atlantica's citizens believe that all 6 children before the legitimate heir were actually Athena's. And for this to work, I would have to cast the spell on Athena as well. Now, all contracts have a clause in case the contract is broken. Mine was he would give me his trident. I didn't actually want it, but with a man like Triton, you have to go big for him to listen. And he agreed. And so beautiful Ariel was born. I'm her godmother, actually. Then Triton betrayed me. Yes, he betrayed me. I was the one witness to his indiscretion in the kingdom. So to silence me, he had to get rid of me. And it was such a simple concept that I can't believe I didn't see it coming. He cheated. I found out, and I came to collect his trident as payment. And when I did, I was surrounded by palace guards, and I had to make a choice. A, I could kill everyone in the room and say it was a coup. B, I could lift the spell, saving me, but even further harming Athena and little Ariel. Or C, I could leave. So I left. And well, rumors, the rumors that Triton spread damaged me so much, I ended up living in the carcass of a dead animal. I never saw Athena before her death. And then Ariel came to me. I wanted to hug her so much, and she was scared of me. So scared and so in love. So it was easier to be the witch of her nightmare than to explain to her what happened. She even would have believed me anyway. Oh. And I won't even go into my contract with Ariel. Now, you thought I was going to let a 16-year-old girl marry a boy she met while he was drowning? But anyway, what was the whole point of me saying all of that? Oh, it doesn't matter. It never will. It doesn't matter that I have contracts with everyone. It doesn't matter that they are at fault for not reading the terms and conditions. It doesn't matter that while there are many souls that I collect, there are even more souls that find salvation. No matter how many wars I've stopped, lives I've saved, I'm the witch. And you're witches too. And you all will forever be tainted by my mistake. Yet you seem to revel in it. So we can't climb out of this hole we're stuck in. So at least let's make it comfortable, huh? I know I can't redo my speech. I, Ursula the Sicilia, am saying to you all, go out there and help some of those poor, unfortunate souls. Hmm?
Day 3. Zuko and Uncle will pay for what they've done. First, they betray their nation, then they abandon me in this wretched asylum. They won't get away with it. But I can wait. Patience is one of my many virtues, and their time will come. I'm confined all day to a stone room. Before they open my cell door, I must put on a pair of ugly gloves that are bound around my wrists and a mask over my face. They've been treated with a substance to prevent me from burning them off, developed by some Hackwater tribe chemist. No matter. I will make a plan and conquer this place before autumn, but until then I must keep my head. Besides, I left a scarlet scratch across an orderly's face my first day, and that has satiated my burning fingers for now. It appears to be healing terribly. Maybe it's even infected. The workers all avoid me now. They only let me leave my room to obtain meals and attend sessions with a doctor named Coelho, who is the most incompetent person I have ever met in my life. She requested I be provided with a journal to write my thoughts and to process what had happened to me. The pages are fireproof as to prevent me from using it destructively. Of course, the entire idea is idiotic, but it gave me a much better one. I will use this journal to document my time here and my rise back to power alongside my father. Then I will publish my memoirs when the Fire Nation rules again, and everyone will know the story of Fire Lord Azula.
No, monster!
Why?
What's that? Who's there?
I see.
Tell me, Sierra. Is it customary for this facility's workers to wake their patients in the middle of the night when they are attempting to get much-needed sleep? Perhaps this is some new medical technique I haven't yet heard of. Noises, well, I'll be sure to mention peculiar noises if your supervisor tomorrow when I explain why I slept through my session. Hello? Day 12. The manipulation here is relentless but laughable. Every day they try to tell me something I know not to be true. The most ridiculous is about the fate of my father, that the Phoenix King is a pitiful, non-bending prisoner rotting away in some dungeon. Clearly, he is somewhere out of the public eye, biding his time, planning his revenge, and preparing to return to his rightful place. Just as I am here. The orderly who disturbed me the other night stopped me in the hallway today. She's a timid non-bender. Some of the boys find her pretty, but she'd clearly be useless in battle. She told me she had something for me and snuck it into my hand when no one else was looking. It was a device with a small sphere at the water of the base, and it tilted back and forth to tap a piece of wood. She said the rhythm helped her sleep at night. She told me she would miss it, but that I could use it for a few days. I thanked her profusely for her generous gift. In a way, I almost wasn't lying. Disrupting the sleep of my guards will only aid in my escape. There. Day 25. I feel a bit like May lately as I've become insufferably bored. I've tried to entertain myself by toying with the orderlies and other residents. I've convinced three other patients that I'm actually the Avatar. Sierra still checks in on me at night, gives me small offerings in secret. Yesterday was cookies from her mother. Huh. I've never thought about Sierra's family before. I wonder if they're as gullible as she is. My strategy with Coelho has evolved throughout my time here. At first, I fabricated tales of gore and horror to terrify her into no longer meeting with me. In between, she would ask about my family, uncle,
and my mother. All such a transparent ploy to no longer gain intelligence from me. Often I got up and left in the middle of a session. Lately, however, I have decided to allow Quelo to believe they are getting through to me. I tell her how I did everything I did because I was frightened, or because I was worried about losing father's love, or that I was afraid Zuko would take my place. Of course she devoured that, though I chose the tritest possible backstory. I have to admit, she does have some skill. She is quite discreet when she waterbends drops into my mask to make me believe I am crying. No! No! It wasn't me, you mongrels! She's a liar! She burnt herself on purpose! You won't get away with this! This is all your fault, Zuzu! Yes! Your fault! I know it is impossible for your diminutive little brain to comprehend such a small concept. It has to be your fault because I do not do these things. Because you're the one who put me here! This place is making me weak. And in becoming weak, I resemble you more and more, Zuzu. Soon, I'll be sporting a stupid ponytail and a blue mask. You want to hear something strange? Sierra sang to me last night. It was a Fire Nation lullaby. I think it was one our mother used to sing. Of course not, Zuzu. It was revolting coming out of her mouth. Those words are meant to calm the children of the greatest people in the world, not for water tribe scum to sedate their prisoners. I was so enraged I couldn't speak. Not even to demand she stop. No, it did not work. Are you dense? What an easy way to poison me. But the whole encounter was exhausting. I finally managed to sleep through the night. Day 85. Things are different now. They have put me on a medicine. My first instinct was refusal. What an easy way to poison me, to incapacitate their greatest threat. But I was not able to stop them. It does not matter. I am stronger than whatever they could give to me. I am Fire Lord Azula. My father is the Phoenix King. The divine blood that pumps through my veins cannot be tainted by whatever these peasants inject into it. I'm seeing Quelo again. Finally. Her burns have mostly healed. She asks how I feel on the medicine. I tell her the truth. I feel less. I feel very little at all. This is meant to intimidate her, but she seems pleased. It is starting to get cold at night. I am very tired. Day 131. Lo and Lee came to visit me. What is wrong with you, Azula, they said. What have they done to you here? The world is different now, Azula. We are disappointed in you. They told me Zuko rules the Fire Nation, that my father has died in his prison cell. Suicide. They asked if I plan to supplant Zuko and take his place there. Faces woke up a little when they asked this. I told them I do not know. When I dream of my plans at night, they fall apart before my eyes. I have no Zuko to outshine, no father to earn the respect of, and no uncle to prove wrong. It has been so long, and I no longer know what I want. Without them, I don't know what my purpose is. I wish Tylee and May would visit me. I told Quelo about the visit. She asked me if I know what I want, but didn't want to tell them. I told her I never wanted something that wasn't for my family, to honor them or destroy them. She asked me what Azula wants. I asked to go back to my cell. At night, I asked Sierra what she really wants. She told me it was hard to say because she has already gotten her greatest wish. The war is over. Her tribe is safe and growing again. She has spent so much time worrying about their safety, their survival as a people, wondering if her father would ever come back from the war. He didn't. But she doesn't have to worry anymore, and she has to learn how to want things for herself again. I told her I understand. I want to tell her my father won't be coming back either. But I thought that she would get upset, so I didn't. Instead, I said that I wonder what my life would be like if there hadn't been a war. She thought we would be friends. I said I don't think we would have met. You know, me being so far in the Fire Nation. She said she hopes I would have help there too. I told her that she sings nicely and asked her to do it again. Day 186. It snowed today. I have never seen snow before. Not like this. Once at the beginning of spring, Father brought me on a mission to the Earth Kingdom, and there was a freak blizzard. Because of our smoke, the snow came down in jet black clumps. What power it showed. So symbolic of what was about to take place. Soon the town was coated in it, dark and cold. I'm allowed to go outside now and even take my mask off sometimes. I was out in the yard drinking tea when I saw the snow. It was just powder when it started, but it covered the ground in moments. It was undisturbed. Pure. The snow piled up on my gloves and I did not move my hands until they were covered. I smiled. It was beautiful. I thought about Sierra and Quelo. I thought about my mother and Zuko and uncle. I thought about the Fire Nation and the South Pole. I thought about this island and this asylum and my cell. I thought of the Water Tribe trinket that I used to fall asleep. I thought of my father and my responsibilities. I thought of what I've done and what I want to do, and I wrote it all down. And I smiled again. I felt a bit of warmth in my cheeks, which have felt numb for so long. And the smile felt real. I have so much to tell Quelo tomorrow.
There's something missing and I'm pissed and I got something to say. Oh yeah. All of the witches and the